Ladies and gentlemen, global nuclear security architecture is a vital component of overall global security architecture. It is built around legally binding conventions like the Convention on Physical Protection of Nuclear Materials and its 2005 amendment, and Nuclear Safety Convention, United Nations Security Council Resolution 1540, passed under Chapter 7, that makes it mandatory for all member states to bring their export control laws and implementation enforcement mechanisms at par with international standards to prevent the non-state actors from gaining access to dangerous materials and technology. Secondly, international norms. Thirdly, informal multilateral arrangements. Fourth, best practices and codes of conduct. And finally, the respective national nuclear security regimes. The fact that nuclear security is a sovereign responsibility of each state has been accepted as a universal principle. However, no state is expected to be complacent or show any laxity in maintaining the highest standards of nuclear security. This is because global security can be likened to a link chain whose strength depends on the strength of each individual link, and any weak link in the chain can cause damage to the whole nuclear security structure. Pakistan, as a responsible nuclear state, has established a comprehensive nuclear security regime that has been disseminated to IAEA member states through IAEA Information Circular 932. The regime is built on three main pillars. First, legislative and regulatory frameworks, including the National Command Authority Law of 2010, the Strategic Export Control Law promulgated in 2004, the Pakistan Nuclear Regulatory Authority Ordinance 2001, and the PAC Act of 1965, to name a few. Secondly, thirdly, the requisite institutions and organizations, including the National Command Authority and its permanent secretariat, the Strategic Plans Division, Strategic Export Controls Division, Pakistan Center of Excellence for Nuclear Security, and its associated institutions, such as the National Institute of Safety and Security, that have been recognized by the IAEA as world-class and have since become a hub of training for regional, international, and national personnel in radiation protection, nuclear emergency management, material protection control and accounting, protection of sensitive materials during transit, and protection of static facilities against malicious acts. And thirdly, appropriate procedures, regulations, and codes of conduct, such as the PNA regulations, export licensing procedures, and implementation regulations issued by the Strategic Export Control Division, personnel reliability program, and promotion of a security culture. Pakistan, beginning in 2005, also implemented a National Nuclear Security Action Plan. Pakistan has also installed radiation detection portals at all entry and exit points, including ground, air, and maritime transit points. In fact, in the past two decades, Pakistan has made greater investment in financial and human resources in augmenting its nuclear security compared with any other nuclear state. It has, over this period, raised a dedicated and professional force for nuclear security comprising around 30,000 personnel, including a rapid response component. Pakistan's effort in this regard have been acknowledged by NTI in its biennial nuclear security indexes. At the international level, former US President Obama initiated the nuclear security summit process in 2010, which culminated in 2016 after the fourth such summit, attended by highest political leadership of key countries as well as international organizations. This brought the nuclear security at the global center stage by sensitizing political leaders to the significance of the subject. As a result, a lot of new ideas emerged, including the conception of centers of excellence for nuclear security. Since the end of this process, the IAEA is overseeing the follow-up actions, especially through its biennial international conferences on nuclear security and the ministerial meeting process. To understand global security trends and challenges at the regional level, one has to contextualize the issue in the broader framework of overall global security architecture, because nuclear security cannot remain immune to changes both positive and negative in the global security environment. In the recent times, the global security environment has been in a flux and has been witnessing an upheaval not experienced since the end of the Cold War. This is mainly due to the intensifying rivalry and competing geostrategic interests of the major powers. The world is witnessing the beginnings of a new armed race between global powers, especially in advanced dual-use technologies such as hypersonic weapons, artificial intelligence, robotics, cyber and space capabilities. Moreover, contrary to the trends witnessed over the past two decades, where the major nuclear powers were drawing down their nuclear arsenals, there is a new competition in introduction of more sophisticated and advanced nuclear weapon systems. And though the new START treaty between the US and the Russian Federation was extended in the nick of time, both US and Russia are continuing the modernization of the nuclear capabilities. Another two of the advanced nuclear states are quantitatively expanding their respective arsenals. Britain, which had resolved to bring